So we're approaching 0 degrees of AOB. It looks like they are going in roughly 260 degrees, slightly west-southwest. Because we're almost heading north exactly, and we don't have them completely at 90 degrees. Looks like it's going to be 80 degrees. Go with this. We don't have much space here, but we should be fine. These are 10-minute intervals. Last one here is a 5-minute interval. Let's see, 3.1 in 15 minutes. Something around 6 knots. Get out of the proximity of their track here. And then we'll turn in on an opposite course in 5.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy.
My crew doesn't see shit without my health. 5,000 meters. Okay. Turn.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy. Neuer Kurs 7-8. Jawohl, Herr Kaloy. Volle Fahrt voraus.
The reason why I attack from the south is because the wind is coming from 154 degrees, which is more southerly than eastern, and the reason that is important is that my periscope sticks out of the water, we'll be moving with the waves, and when we're moving against the waves, the periscope might create bigger splashes than when the waves are coming with the movement of the boat. The relative speed will be lower. Yeah, that's the tactical advice they give in the Kommandantenhand. So we're on track here, let's dive. And let's adjust our course slightly. That's a bit too much. Perfect.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy, ein Drittel Fahrt voraus.
Excellent.
Kontakt, Frachter, kommt näher auf 348. Große Entfernung.
Yeah, I think we have to turn in. Go hard rudder port. And that will be 350.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy. Neuer Kurs 349. Jawohl, Herr Kaloy. Große Fahrt voraus.
So this first ship here is an M2 type freighter, 5,000 tons. and the second one is a Colonial Freighter, and the last one is a big freighter, I think it's called. Over 8,000 tons, so that's for sure priority target. And I think we'll let the... I think we'll attack the Colonial Freighter with one torpedo, and then once it has passed, once it's about that maybe 10 to 15 degrees on our port side, and we will slow down, and we'll attack this guy with a salvo of 2, I think, 9 meters. Let's put this up here. Nice. And then let's select 2-2 for the Colonial Freighter.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Ziel wird identifiziert.
With one torpedo. Okay. Now let's see if we have to back up a little bit. That we will get the bearing of the first ship and see how far it is. Well, actually, the first ship doesn't matter. This guy matters. 80. That's still quite far out, I think. Yeah. He's over here. That translate to 3.6. That's over 15 minutes. In 15 minutes at 2 knots, we will cover. Yeah, that's too much. We have to back up.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Kleine Fahrt zurück.
When we back up for 5 minutes, that puts us back to 1,000 meters. And he will be close. He'll be at 2.7. He needs another 15 minutes. We'll back up for 10 minutes. Now it's 1:50. We'll go slow ahead again. 2 o'clock in the morning. And on a first pass, we'll let this guy go and we'll catch up with him later and attack him as well. Okay, I think I can time compress here until 55 and then we'll take an next bearing. Okay, so the Colonial Freighter is at 66. kilometers. And 6 knots, a bit more than 10 minutes. I will back up for another 5 minutes to be on the safe side. I want to have exactly 350, so I'm gonna correct this here. Better. So the colonial freighter cover. .6 in 5 minutes. Seems like a lot. I mean, these ships are capable of that speed, but true, they would be going really fast. On the other hand, N20, 30, 40. I don't think the colonial freighter is going that fast. It would actually surprise me. Can we set up the salvo for N.5? It loses its setting. That's annoying. Anyway, okay, let's go ahead again. Let's measure colonial freighter speed here. 34. Nine knots. Okay. Go with maybe 8. Distance is roughly 1100, 1200. Measure again. And a half knot. It seems quite fast. Let's leave it at 8. And let's actually shoot. Or are they apart? About 20 degrees. So let's shoot when he passes here. Now let's switch over. Elbow shot. And let's shoot this guy. And here, let's spread to 2.5 maybe. Sorry, at 1,000 meters. Okay, so they're a bit lower, I think. We hit them ahead. Switch over. They are looking now for torps. There is one hit, and there is a second hit. Let's first of all go up here. more people in here. Okay, let's take a look. It's purely for cinematic and show reasons, obviously. But I mean, we would have access to the same information through the periscope. The thing is, we hit this big freighter twice, and it has not stopped. We did not score a critical hit on him. Now, we could measure his speed. Current speed, anyway. I'm pretty sure they are zigzagging. We still have one tube left. I don't know if they can see the periscope or not. Lower it a bit. He's 156 meters long, 53 seconds. What kind of angle and bow is this? That's it. Yeah, it seems about right. Go for another shot here. What's wrong here?
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Rohr 3, los!
I didn't readjust the distance, but since we're so close, it shouldn't play too big a role. We will have to go for some follow-up shots, I think, as well for the Colonial Breaker. That is another hit amidships, but I think it's a bit too far ahead again. We've overestimated the speed. Probably a hit again in the same section, so I'm not sure what that means. Gonna increase his flooding? Probably not. Anyway, we have to turn here.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Ruder 4-0, Grad Backbord. Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Volle Fahrt voraus.
I don't know if we can man the deck gun. at this wind speed, wave height anyway. Let's go on a parallel course.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloy. Neuer Kurs 260.
We're looking fine. Who is he? That is amazing. And three tour pits and he's still up. I know, I've been complaining about the sinking duration. There's another contact back here. Can't see anything though. Just yet. What's going on with these guys? There are secondary explosions going off on the Colonial Freighter. Status on the torps here. And then probably can't load. Let's go deep for a while so we can load the torps. And let's speed ahead. And I'll get back to you when I have decided on the next steps.